Day one in the Highland Forest of Costa Rica, and it's pouring rain. So gorgeous though. If I could escape, I would, but first of all, let me say, I must apologize for acting, stinking, treating you this way. Cause I've been acting like sour milk all on the floor. It's your fault, you didn't shut the refrigerator. Maybe that's the reason I've been acting so cold. If I could escape and recreate a place, it's my own world, and I could be your favorite girl forever, perfectly together. And tell me, boy, now wouldn't that be sweet? If I could be sweet,
right now, no, it's hard to see, but it's just like, let's say like 3, like 9 o'clock here, let's see if she moves again, if she moves again.
Come on, let's bounce. Counting on you to turn me around. Instead of clowning around, let's look for some common ground. So baby, time's getting a little crazy. I've been getting a little lazy, waiting you to come save me. I can see that you're angry by the way that you treat me. Hopefully you don't leave me. Wanna take you with me.
If I could escape and recreate a place, it's my own. Together and tell me, boy, now wouldn't that be sweet? If I could be sweet, I know I've been a real bad girl. I didn't mean for you to get hurt. We can make it better. And tell me, boy, now wouldn't that be sweet?
That they have is not considered the best one, and it's because the way that they have it to take the coffee or to collect is different. They have a huge machines, like big trucks, that they get into the field and they shake the, you know, the plants, and all the coffee beans are going down to the ground. So after that, people is coming to picking up all the coffee beans that they find in the ground. So we don't do that. We collect the coffee by hand, you know, little by little. So in that way, you make sure that you are only collecting the very right and good seeds, and the rest one that they don't look that well, we just don't use it, or you don't collect. So that is one of the reasons, because our quality is considered a very good one.
Come for me. there's about maybe about 30 or 40 people living there, perhaps in this little village. But the only fact of these people living there makes them, or makes the animals, fear humans. You know why? Because indigenous people, as you know, they're used to go in the jungle and hunt. So they have been killing monkeys to eat, they have been killing peccaries, they have been killing armadillos, they have been killing pacas, they have been killing even jaguars. You know, so animals usually move away from humans that will hurt them. You know, I'm not saying that it's bad. Everything has to be sustainable, and indigenous societies know how to do that pretty well. The problem comes when a society becomes greedy, and then you start killing to sell and make money, killing to sell and make money, things like that. But if you kill to survive, it's seen with good eyes. All this belongs to the lodge, the Costa Rican stream, and this limits with an indigenous reserve known as Nairi Awari that has about 5,000 hectares. It's about 12,000 acres, I think, of forest. And all this connects with one of the largest national parks in Costa Rica. It's an international park known as La Amistad. So there's about 350,000 hectares of land protected here, more than 700,000 acres. You can start walking from this jungle, just through the jungle, and reach Panama through the jungle, you know? Only forest and forest and forest and forest. This is the last pristine forest found in Costa Rica, and these are the most dense and diverse jungles that you will find anywhere, you know? If you mark a hectare right here, a plot, if you make a plot of 1 hectare, you will find more diversity of species here than anywhere else in the planet. The Amazon is the richest forest of the world, yes, but if you mark a plot of 1 hectare in the Amazon and 1 in Costa Rica, you will find more species here, in that plot. See what I mean? So it's more diverse per unit of area. Yeah, more plants, you know, in one specific area. But if you mark a plot of 200 miles, you know, obviously the Amazon will win, for sure, because there's more species there. Just one last thing before we get in. I want you to see that tree over there, that large tree. Yeah, that one, no, it's similar to the rubber one, yes. That one is what we know as golden fruit, fruta dorada. And that's one of the sacred species for many of the natives. You will find it, you will find them in the forest growing huge. Some of them have been cut down for timber. But the indigenous people still in South America, not anymore in Costa Rica, they strip the bark and they collect the sap and they cook the sap and they add some extra leaves. And once it's cooked, it gets very thick. And when it's thick, they dry it in the sun. When it's dry, it hardens. When once it's hard, you mash it, make it into a powder. And then you put that, that's from the fruit?
No, it's from the water.
And then you put that into a bamboo cane, put the end of the bamboo in your mouth and the other end in the nostril of someone, and then you blow that powder, making it one of the strongest hallucinogenics known from nature. You know, that tree over there. And what is even more amazing is the fact that these people know how to use it on a sacred way without having to prostitute that, like our society usually do, you know? But you might wonder how the indigenous people managed to discover something like this, you know? And many people will say, trial and error is the answer. But to me, it's something more complex than that. You know, trial and error makes sense when you say this leaf is good for 2 days, like the leaf you tried. Why? Because it's just simple. You just grab the leaf, you chew, you feel numbing, and you say, okay, it works. But then when you have to cut the bark, extract the sap, cook it, add leaves, dry it, mash it, sniff it, it's more complex. It's harder to find out that just by trial and error. So if you ask the indigenous societies, they will tell you it's because we talk to the planet. For our society, that's crazy. That's impossible, because we usually try to explain everything from our point of view and we don't see other point of view. You know, we think that we are the only ones that are right. That's our problem. We don't see that there's people somewhere else living with different ways, and they manage to survive without electricity, without computer, without internet, without iPods, without many of the things that we have right now. Listen to the sounds of the jungle for a minute, and then we will do it when we're almost out, that it's going to be a little darker, right? You can just hear the river and all the insects.
Faster than